Good morning, Travis Park Church. Thanks so much for being a part of our gathering this morning. Wherever you are, and we have people watching from all over, wherever you are, it's our prayer that you know God's love for you, embracing you right where you are this morning, and that you're equipped. As we're in our superhero series, I'm Mr. Incredible today. We're going to be talking about Spider-Man and how with great power comes great responsibility. And so we pray that you receive God's love and that you're equipped and encouraged to go out and share what God has freely given you and me. So thanks for being here this morning. We would love to stay connected. And so if you'd leave a comment here, that would be great to let us know that you're watching. But most of all, if you would go to travispark.org/contact, if everybody could do this, we're trying a new contact card thing. You can also put prayer requests there. We'd love to stay in touch and that'll help us. So travispark.org/contact. Again, thanks for being here. I'm so glad to be with you all and thankful for our church. Thanks for being a part of it. Let's worship together.
Let's sing together. Here we go. Through you, I can do anything. I can do all things, 'cause it's you who gives me strength. Nothing is impossible. Through you, blind eyes are open, strongholds are broken. I am living by faith. Nothing is impossible. Not gonna live by what I see. I'm not gonna live by what I feel. Deep down I know that you're here with me. And I know that you can do anything. Through you I can do anything. I can do all things, 'cause it's you who gives me strength. Nothing is impossible. Through you, blind eyes are open, strongholds are broken. I am living by faith. Nothing is impossible. Not gonna live by what I see. I'm not gonna live by what I feel. Deep down I know that you're here with me. I know that you can do anything. Through you I can do anything. I can do all things, 'cause it's you who gives me strength. Nothing is impossible. Through you, blind eyes are open, strongholds are broken. I am living by faith. Nothing is impossible. Let's sing. I believe, I believe, I believe, I believe, I believe in you. I believe, I believe, I believe, I believe in you. I believe, I believe, I believe, I believe in you. I believe, I believe, I believe, I believe in you. I can do anything. I can do all things, 'cause it's you who gives me strength. Nothing is impossible through you. Blind eyes are open. Strong bones are broken. I am living by faith. Nothing is impossible. I believe in you. I believe in you. Amen. Amen.
Jesus sent these 12 out and commanded them, "Don't go among the Gentiles or into a Samaritan city. Go instead to the lost sheep, the people of Israel. As you go, make this announcement: the kingdom of heaven has come near. Heal the sick, raise the dead, cleanse those with skin diseases, and throw out demons. You received without having to pay. Therefore, give without demanding payment. Workers deserve to be fed, so don't gather gold or silver or copper coins for your money belts to take on your trips. Don't take a backpack for the road or two shirts or sandals or a walking stick. Whatever city or village you go into, find somebody in it who is worthy and stay there until you go on your way. When you go into a house, say peace. If the house is worthy, give it your blessing of peace. But if the house isn't worthy, take back your blessing. If anyone refuses to welcome you or listen to your words, shake the dust off your feet as you leave that house or city. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Thanks be to God."
Friends, a real highlight of this summer for me was our Illustrated Ministry Compassion Camp that we did for Vacation Bible School online this year. We had over 40 kids and families participating from places all across the United States. With my kids, we moved pretty slowly through it, but this week as we finished up, and the curriculum is being taken offline tomorrow, as we finished up, we prayed this prayer, and I thought it was fitting as we get into today's prayer. So will you pray with me as our Compassion Camp families have prayed? You are active and alive, always moving and stirring within and around us. Please be an encouraging wind at our backs, giving us open minds and soft hearts to follow where you lead. Make us flexible and present in this time and in each moment, that we might embrace compassion by letting go of what we expected. Amen. We're continuing our series on God's superheroes this week. And last week we reflected on Wonder Woman and the leadership of Deborah in the book of Judges. And I loved getting to hear and share about our recovery ministry, Deborah's House, last week. 2 weeks ago with our back to school blessing, we looked at the school in which the diversely gifted mutants known as the X-Men were enrolled with Professor Xavier. That week we looked at the Luke 9 parallel to the scripture that Linda read today for us in Matthew chapter 10, where Jesus sent out the 12 apostles for the first time on their own. Jesus equipped and empowered and commissioned them to go and do what he himself had been doing and what he had mentored them to do, to go and multiply his work of pointing to the presence and the new reality that comes with the reign, the realm, the family of God. Go heal the sick, Jesus said. Throw out the demons. Proclaim in both words and actions that God's kingdom is here on earth as it is in heaven. Both in Luke chapter 9 that we looked at 2 weeks ago and in Matthew chapter 10 today, there's an emphasis on what not to take. Don't take a backpack. Don't take a walking stick or a second shirt. Don't take a wallet full of money. Instead, go and depend on the training and the power that Jesus has given you. Go out two by two and depend on each other. And go out and depend on the hospitality of the people who welcome you into their homes and into their lives. Taking little material stuff at Jesus' instructions means then a highlight on what they are taking: the very presence and message of the reign of God. They're bringing power to restore creation to God's will. They're bringing the good news of a fresh start and an alternative to the death-dealing ways of empire. They're going and saying and showing that a good ruler is here. The rightful sovereign is here to set you free to be all who God made you to be. Caesar being in charge, money and fame and power being in charge, even you yourself being in charge, it hasn't worked out too well. So let's try. The apostles went out saying, sharing Jesus' good news. Let's try letting God be in charge. Matthew 10 records Jesus as saying something not included in Luke chapter 9. Matthew 10, verse 8, it says, you received, Jesus tells the apostles, the disciples, you received without having to pay. Therefore, give without demanding payment. Many translations put this more simply, Matthew 10, 8, freely you have received, freely give. With all that you've been given out of God's generosity comes this responsibility to share it. All you've been given, it's not just for you. Part of the way that this free and abundant gift that you've been given, part of the way it works is that you have to pass it on. Grace. Grace is God giving us better than we deserve, unconditionally, at no cost, no earning for us, with God paying the tab for us, simply because God loves you and me and all of creation. But if you're going to recognize grace as grace, if you're going to receive this free gift with thanksgiving, then you also have to pass it on in the same free and abundant and unconditional way that it came to you. In other words, with great power comes great responsibility. It had been said before, notably by Winston Churchill, but with great power comes great responsibility really became a proverb for us through the Spider-Man comic. It's part of Spider-Man's origin story from the original 1962 Amazing Fantasy comic from Stan Lee. Peter Parker is this 18-year-old who had been bitten by this genetically engineered spider, right? And Parker is in the middle of discovering these strange new powers of web slinging and super spider sense and amazing jumping and strength. And he's discovering his powers and he's changing. Almost like an extra like mutant puberty or something. And he's making these changes and learning about his powers when he hears these words, with great power comes great responsibility. He hears them from his Uncle Ben, who's been raising Peter with Aunt May since Peter's parents have passed away. So let's watch this, try and watch this short clip now. I hope this works. And then you can get a little more context for the clip and the speech from Uncle Ben by going to the YouTube video link that we're posting in the comments on Facebook. The YouTube video link should be here at the bottom of the screen, but we'll show just a few seconds of it if this works now.
This guy, Flash Thompson, he probably deserved what happened. But just because you can beat him up doesn't give you the right to. Remember, with great power comes great responsibility.
With great power comes great responsibility. As we see, Uncle Ben doesn't know about Peter's new Spidey powers, but he does know that Peter is changing. And Uncle Ben says, these are the years when a man changes he's going to become for the rest of his life. Just be careful, he says, who you change into. Just because you can beat up this bully Flash, that doesn't give you the right to. Remember, Uncle Ben says, with great power comes great responsibility. Friends, given all the gifts and the tasks that we freely and unconditionally and abundantly receive from God, from the God who spoke the universe into being, who conquered even death, given all that power, what's our responsibility? Given all that power, what are you going to do with it? Who are you going to choose to be? For Peter, at first he wants to use his powers for himself, right? He beats up this bully, and given an opportunity to stop a thief, he lets the thief pass on by and go free. And he says, you know, it's not my problem. But then when it turns out, and spoiler alert here, for the 2002 movie, it turns out that Uncle Ben gets killed by the same thief that Peter, Spider-Man, could have stopped earlier. And then Peter realizes that he does have responsibility to care for others with the powers that he's been given, that were connected. All this lines up as a contrast. There's a foil in the 2002 Sam Raimi, Tobey Maguire Superman movie. And there's this contrast with the way that Norman Osborn selfishly chooses to use his powers as the Green Goblin. And so we have these alternatives. That's this great choice that Peter and Norman and each of us faces. What are you going to do with what you've been given? What are you going to do with what you've been given? Will you seek power for yourself for the sake of garnering more power? Or will you give your power and your life away on behalf of others? Green Goblin says to Spider-Man, "You chose your path. You chose the way of the hero. Why bother?" Green Goblin asks Spider-Man. And Spider-Man says, "Because it's right." This is the same choice that Wonder Woman recognized last week, and that Professor Xavier recognized before, two weeks ago. You know, as we saw last week, as Wonder Woman said it, it's not about what they deserve. It's about what you believe. The 2002 Spider-Man movie ends with Parker recalling, "With great power comes great responsibility," for the third time in the movie, just to ram it home. He recalls, "With great power comes great responsibility," for the third time. He said, and at the end of the movie, he says, "This is my gift. These powers I've been given, this is my gift in this task. This is my gift. And," he says, "this is my curse. It's hard work with personal sacrifice. But if you're going to acknowledge the gift, then you have to take the task that comes along with the gift as well. Freely you have received. Freely give. Freely you've received, freely give." It's not the only place that Jesus says something like, "With great power comes great responsibility." In Luke 12, 48, which we'll put on the screen here, in Luke 12, 48, Jesus tells the disciples, "Much will be demanded from those who have been given much. And from those entrusted with much, even more will be demanded." I like how the Message sums up this verse, Luke 12, 48. Great gifts mean great responsibilities. Greater gifts, greater responsibilities. So friends, what is it that you've been given? What great gifts? What great responsibilities? Where did these gifts come to you with a responsibility given you by God to share your gifts with others, to share the gift and the superpower that God gave uniquely you, that only you can share with the world? What's the platform, the microphone, the megaphone, the sphere of influence that you've been given to share that gift? Something that our Racial Justice Sunday School class, which you're all invited to at 11 o'clock, something that we've been discussing. For those of us who have white privilege and other privileges that we've been given, when we acknowledge that we've been given some privilege, that we've been given some unique power, some gifts, some head start that we didn't deserve and others didn't get. When we have that privilege, we recognize that we have that privilege. How do we learn to use that privilege, that power? Use it not to build ourselves up, but use that privilege to lift up others, to share our gifts rather than just deny that our privilege exists. I believe everyone has gifts to share. In a unique place, unique power, where God is calling each of us to share those gifts. I love that this past week, following the police shooting of Jacob Blake in Wisconsin, a number of pro athletes have used their platform. They've said, "We're not just going to shut up and dribble. We're going to use our place and our gifts to say hard truths that we all need to hear." It's similar to what the Dixie Chicks, now called the Chicks, when they were told to shut up and sing back during the Iraq War. But you don't have to be a superhero or a sports or music superstar to have a platform, to have a gift and a responsibility to share that gift, to have a sphere of influence where God's put you with the gifts that you need. the corollary to with great power comes great responsibility for Jesus is earlier in that Luke 12 passage. And in Luke 16 and Matthew 25 elsewhere, where Jesus basically says, those who are faithful in a little will be faithful with much. So when you're faithful to share and pass along the little things, then you'll be given more gifts with more responsibility. Our job as a church, why we come together, for now virtually mostly, but why we're in each other's lives, why we support each other, why we gather, our job as a church, the gift we've been given, the responsibility we've been given, our task, it's to help each other recognize the gifts that God has freely and abundantly given us. The good news, the grace that God has given us, it's not just for us. Our job is to recognize those gifts and then to help one another to share them. And that's why when we recognize new members, as we're doing today with Harry and Belia and Doc and Bernice and Alex, I hope you'll get to know them and reach out to them. When we recognize new members, we're all promising. They're promising, but we're all renewing our vows, renewing our promise. We're promising to one another and to God that we will share our prayers, our presence, our gifts, our service, and our witness. Prayers, presence, gifts, service, witness. We can share all these things. We have a responsibility to share all these things because of the gifts that God has given us, gifts that we didn't earn. It's because of who God is and how God has lovingly pursued us that we have grace and we have gifts to give, to share with others. We can pray because God reached out to us first. We can be present because God gave the gift of God's own presence. We share our financial gifts and our time gifts and our talents, all our words and actions to point to God's reign and realm in witness. We give these things, we share these things because God gave all these powers and resources to us and for us in order that we might share them even more widely, even more freely. So friends, what's your next faithful step? Do you need to acknowledge the gifts that God's given you? Is it hard for you to look in the mirror and say, I have superpowers? Or is it hard for you to say, what I have is something given me by God. It's not something that I earned on my own. Or do you need to recognize that with your gifts come responsibilities, that God has put a unique task before you, a place of influence, and given you the resources, the authority, the power, the superpower, to do that responsibility in the place where God's put you. God gives, friends, because God loves. And so may we learn, too, to give and to love as God does, freely and abundantly and for the sake of others. Even if our powers and our responsibilities feel small, may we be faithful in a little that we might learn to be faithful in much. May we do, as is attributed to Mother Teresa, may we do small things with great love. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Good morning, Travis Park Church. I hope you're having a great Sunday morning. Today, as we welcome new members into our community, we will pray a prayer inspired by the Apostles' Creed. If you would like to join in the words, they will be on the screen for us to say together. Now, remember, we want to stay connected with you and all of us, the new members and old members and anything in between. We want to stay connected with you. You can go to travispark.org/contact. Please fill out that contact card, not only to submit your attendance, but also to submit those prayer requests. We'll collect those through our contact card online. That's travispark.org/contact. We will take those prayers and collect them for our prayer circle on Wednesday night and our online Zoom prayer gathering on Thursdays. And so we collect those prayers and say them together as a community in various different ways through Corazon and Travis Park Church. So that's how you pray with us again now virtually, going to travispark.org/contact. So let us pray this prayer based on the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, who speaks through the prophets and lifts our gaze up to high and beautiful paths and peaks. I believe in Christ Jesus, free of corruption, yet willingly numbered among the sinners, baptized into the waters of the Jordan. I believe in the Spirit, who rested on Jesus like a dove, and who inspired him with such love as the world has not seen before or since. I believe that those who are one with Christ shall share his spirit, his mission, and his ultimate victory over sin and death. I believe there is no human ability that cannot be enlarged or no weakness that cannot be used by Christ to the praise of God. I believe that this is believing is a gift from God, not to be used for self-gratification, but for the building up of others and for the humble service to the world. I believe in myself as a child of God, the recipient of healing grace. With the help of God, I will live my belief all the days of my life. Amen. God in community, holy and one, give us your peace as we pray as Jesus taught us, saying, Our loving God, who is in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. We want to welcome those new members into this beloved community. We are here for you and are glad you are part of this journey together. Now we'll enter this part of the service online for our offering. We know we believe, and we say this each and every week, that everyone has something to offer through your prayers, through your gifts, through your tithe, through your offering. And so please go to travispark.org/donate. This is very crucial in this time as we're trying to live life in new, different ways and to serve each other in different ways. We want to keep this ministry going by going to travispark.org/donate. There you can submit pledges and your gifts, and we are grateful to be in this community together. And we all have something to offer, and that is something beautiful to celebrate. Have a good morning and welcome new members.
Excited that technology makes it possible to welcome new members into our community. We have five folks who want to make their connection to Travis Park Church more official. So I'll introduce them and ask them the membership question. And then I'm going to close this time with a prayer that we usually pray as a congregation when we welcome new members. So we'll introduce them one by one. First is Harry and Belia Call. Harry and Belia have a long history with Travis Park Church. Their son has served on staff with Travis Park. Their daughter and grandkids have also been a part of our community. Terry is a retired pastor, so his membership technically belongs to the conference, but he wanted to stand with Balia and our community. So we're going to be his church in his retirement, though, of course, neither of y'all are the kind to just sit around in retirement. They're both active in several things we do in the church. They've stayed connected, joining with the church over Zoom in our small groups during this pandemic. So we're grateful that y'all are part of our community. We've got Alexandra Zimmeron, and she has been connecting with Travis Park Church along with her partner Patrick Stewart for a few years. They've joined with the other young adults in our congregation for fellowship before the pandemic hit, and they're able to join us on Sunday mornings virtually. So we're so grateful that y'all are part of our community, and Alexandra, that you're ready to join the church. And last, we've got Richard, who goes by Doc, and his wonderful wife, Bernice Wittenbach Santos. They've recently moved to San Antonio to be closer to some of their family. They've long been connected to the Methodist Church and are glad to have found a reconciling church. They met a few years ago on Guam and have many years of church and community leadership. And we're grateful for the gifts that y'all will bring, especially with your years of service. So thanks for joining us and being a part of Travis Park Church. We're going to bring everyone on screen so that I can ask all of y'all question. I am so grateful. We at Travis Park are so grateful for the gifts that each of you bring to our community, especially during this pandemic. It's a real gift and a joy to celebrate welcoming new folks into our community. So thanks for being a part of this strange new world of doing things digitally, using technology like this. I'm so grateful that I got to hear more of your stories over Zoom and get to know you a little bit more. Hopefully other folks will get to connect with you as well, even in the midst of this physical distancing. So you are a blessing to the community. I just want to make it official. Here's the question. As members of this congregation, will you faithfully participate in its ministries by your prayers, your presence, your gift, your service, and your witness? If you will, say, I will.
I will.
Awesome. Thanks, y'all. So normally as a congregation, we pray together a prayer that I'm now going to pray on behalf of our community for y'all. So let me pray this prayer of thanksgiving and partnership for our journey. Let's pray. The journey of faith is a journey through life, and we are fellow travelers making our way. As we walk together, we share our stories and our questions, our successes and our failures, respecting the dignity of God's image in us all. We beckon you to join us on this journey, and we make a place for you here. Remember always, the family of God is your family too. Amen.
Amen.
All for being a part of our community. We're so grateful to celebrate with you. So thanks for being members of Travis Park Church. We'll cheer. Normally the congregation cheers because we're so grateful for y'all. So y'all.
Friends, as we are sent out in discipleship, want to be sure to draw your attention to ways that we're staying in touch with each other, ways that we're connecting, ways that we're communicating so that we can stay connected to each other and in service to the world around us. So if you're not yet on our email newsletter list, please do email info@travispark.org so that way you can receive those weekly updates with all of the details and more information about Zoom links and all those things that you need to be able to connect with us. If you're on our Facebook group, we are so excited you're here, especially if you're watching worship with us. Be sure to sign in as well as to use that connect card on our website to let us know prayer joys and concerns. If you have questions or are ever wondering what's happening, please do check out our website, www.travispark.org. You'll find all kinds of information there. things like our Zoom coffee time. I love seeing folks on Sunday mornings after worship. So whenever we wrap up, usually around 10:30 or so, we gather for that time of connecting. It's especially fun when folks have their pets and their kids and all that good stuff. So feel free to come as you are and connect with us during that time. We have Zoom Sunday School at 11 a.m. Wednesday nights, we've got Pub Theology online. Pastor Gavin facilitates that with other leaders from the community, sometimes hosting, and it's exciting to see what things are happening each week. Our own Erica was a part of last week's, and we've got more folks coming up in the coming weeks that should be really exciting. Thursday evenings, we've got our prayer meeting that Pastor Eric facilitates, and I'm really excited now that students are getting back to school. College students are engaging in school, and one of the ways that I'm staying connected with them is by gathering on Zoom. And something exciting that we're trying this year, because we can do it over Zoom, is Tuesdays we're going to have midday prayer at noon. We'll use just a simple liturgy. We'll gather together. So that's students from San Antonio College, that's students from Trinity University, that's myself, as well as the church is invited, your friends are invited, whoever might need that time of rest and prayer, want to invite them to that brief Tuesday midday prayer. Details for that are in our newsletter. I'm also really excited that in this time of physical distancing but staying connected, we are welcoming new members into our community, folks who have been a part of our family but are making that official with their membership being placed with our congregation and community. So that's what's up next, and I'm grateful for their presence. I'm grateful for your presence. I'm grateful that we can be sent out to love and serve the world.
Friends, thanks so much. It's so great to have gathered together in worship today to offer our gifts, to learn about the task that God's put before us, and just pray a blessing on you as you go out to live that task and share God's good news freely and abundantly, unconditionally. Love and justice in action, given by God through us for all. I'm grateful to get to do that work with all of you. It's great to get to welcome new members today. So welcome again to Harry and Belia, Alex, Doc and Bernice, We're so grateful you're a part of our community. There'll be more opportunities soon for becoming a member of the church, making that commitment official for baptisms. So be looking for that. You can talk to me or to Pastor Valerie about those things. Again, if we can help you stay connected, we'd really love to. And one way to do that is travispark.org/contact. So please check that out and leave your information there and prayer requests and prayer praises. We love praying those on Thursday nights. So, yeah, thanks again for being part of it. Hear this blessing, this benediction as we go. Friends, may the Spirit bless you with hope, poured out like water and flowing as the river. May Jesus bless you with discomfort at injustice and oppression. May the Creator who holds the earth as an artist holds brush and palette, may that Creator fill your imagination so that you always find the world inspiring and beautiful. May God, in whose being beauty shines on you, journey with you. Friends, God says to you, you are my beloved. Be blessed this day and always. Friends, go and share super peace and superpower from our super God. Thanks. Take care.